this video, we're going to continue on with accounting and the time value of money, and we're going to be specifically looking at future value of a single or lump sum. So we're just going to jump right in with some examples. Here we have Brugger Company. They want to determine the future value of $50,000 invested today over 5 years compounded annually at an interest rate of 11%. So when we're looking at a question like this, we have to ask ourselves a few questions. First off, which table do we use? So to determine that, we have a couple of questions. First off, is it a future value or a present value question? Well, let's start there. It says that we're going to invest $50,000 today. So that really means we know the present value is $50,000. And we want to know what it's going to be worth at the end of 5 years. So that's a future value question. Now we have to say, well, is it a lump sum? Are we investing one amount? Or are we investing the same amount over multiple years? Well, in this situation, we're investing a one-time amount of $50,000. So that makes this a single or lump sum problem. So we're going to need our future value of a lump sum table. So when you look at your tables, if you have those with you or in front of you or in your textbook, you can see a little snippet of your larger tables. And I'm using the future value of a dollar, which you can also call future value of a single sum or future value of a lump sum. And we're specifically looking at an interest rate of 11%. And it was over 5 years, compounded annually. So that's compounded once a year. So 1 times 5 years is 5 periods. So that would be our N. So you find your percentage column, which in this case is 11%, so right there in the middle, and you scroll all the way down until you get to 5 periods. And you find that the factor that you're going to use is 1.68506. So you're going to take that factor and multiply that times the present value amount of that lump sum. Remember, that factor takes all that into consideration, the periods, the interest rate, the compounding, all that. So you multiply that times that lump sum amount, and that gives you your future value. So now what this is telling us is if we invested $50,000 today at 11% compounded annually, at the end of 5 years, we would have accumulated $84,253. So now let's you try one. So here we have Robert Anderson. They invested $15,000 today in a fund that earns 8% compounded annually. To what amount will the investment grow in 3 years? So remember the questions you have to ask yourself, push pause on your player, and then come back and we'll look at it together. Okay, so now remember, you have to ask yourself certain questions. The first one is this a future value or a present value question? Since we're investing $15,000 today, present value, so we know the present value, and we're looking for how much this will be in 3 years. Well, that's a future value. So we know it's a future value question because we don't know what it's going to be worth in the future. Is it a lump sum or an annuity problem? Well, we're going to invest $15,000 today, and that's it, no more. So that makes this a lump sum problem. So when we go to look at our tables, we're going to find the future value of a lump sum table. It's compounded annually over 3 years. So since it's compounded once a year, that's 1 times 3 years, so our periods will be 3, compounded at 8%. So we're going to look for 8% in our lump sum future value table, and we're going to go all the way down to 3 periods, so that makes our factor 1.25971. And again, your table may be slightly different by 1 or 2 digits, and that's fine, it's just rounding. And so you're going to take that factor, which incorporates everything, compounding, the percentage, the periods, everything, multiply that times the lump sum amount, and that will give you your future value of $18,896. Again, meaning if we invest $15,000 today at 8% interest over the next 3 years, it will accumulate $18,896. In that account. So basically it's earned $3,896 in interest. Now you can call this way shorthand if you like, but we can also prove it longhand. If we look at this little spreadsheet, in year one we started with $15,000. at 8% interest. At the end of year one, we would have earned $1,200 in interest. So our new balance in that account would be $16,200. Because it's compounded, that would be what we would start with the next year. $16,200 times our interest rate of 8% gives me interest at the end of year two, earning $1,296. Therefore, my balance at the end of year two would be $17,496. That would be the beginning balance of year three times our interest rate of 8%. During year three, I would earn $1,400 in interest, leaving me at the end of year three with that $18,896 that we said before that we would earn using the shorthand method, our time value of money tables. But recall, interest is not always compounded annually. It can be compounded monthly, it can be compounded quarterly, it can be compounded semi-annually, etc. So what do we do in those cases? Well, let's look at this problem here. We're just going to alter our last problem just a little bit with Robert Anderson. Instead of it being compounded annually, we're going to compound it semi-annually. So it's the same problem. So we know it's a future value problem. We know that we're starting with $15,000 we're investing today. We're not going to put any more in there, just a lump sum of $15,000. It's going to earn 8% over 3 years. But now, instead of being compounded once a year, it's going to be compounded twice a year. And we've got to calculate the number of periods that we have. Well, if it's compounded twice a year for 3 years, then we have six periods. Twice a year, 2 times 3 is 6. So, for example, if it had been compounded quarterly, that's compounded 4 times a year. So then we would have 12 periods. So in this case, we have 6 because it's semi-annually. So we're going to go right back to our future value of a lump sum or single value or future value of a single sum table. And we're going to look for that 6 period number. But since it's earning 8% and it's compounded semi-annually, we actually have to cut our interest rate in half in that case. Because again, it is compounded semi-annually twice a year. So 8% for the full year or 4% per 6 months. Okay, so we're going to look for 4% and go down to our 6 periods. That gives me a factor of 1.26532. You multiply that times your present value amount, and that gives you your new future value of $18,980 if it's compounded semi-annually. And again, remember, if this had been compounded quarterly, our interest rate would have been 2%. So we have 8% annually, but now it's being compounded 4 times a year. So 8% divided by 4 is 2% per quarter. And our periods, we have 3 years that it's being compounded 4 times a year. So we'd end up with 12 periods.